It must have been one of his ringtones which he'd played manually.
もう一回行くぞ。じゃ、最低限のマナーだけでも教えてやろう。
そうだな。
どう考えてもおかしいだろ。なんでお前が同意してんだよ。
同意すんのは他のやつの役目だな。
じゃあそうだなは俺が言ってやろう。
俺は？
ホモだけどな、デタロ。
オッケ
ー。もう一回だけ行くぞ。じゃあ最低限のマナーだけでも教えてやろう。
そうだな。
ホモだけどな。
We entered in unison and bowed.
Yosh, Kejime wa kanjin da kara na.
He opened his cell phone again and pressed the button. A button. This time a correct answer tone came out.
Mazu wa atte saisho no aisatsu da. Riki, yatte miro.
I'm delighted to make your acquaintance. I'm Riki Naoi from Class 2E. I'll be showing you around today.
行業しすぎやしないか？学生なんだから、はじめまして、ナオエです。ぐらいの方がさっぱりしてていいだろう。
Well then. Hello, I'm Naoi from Class 2E. Pleased to meet you.
よし、リンも行け。
うん、私も今のは良かったと思う。
No, it's your turn.
行けというのは、お前もやれという意味だ。誰がお前に感想を求めた？
何？
なんかお前、さっきから教える側に立っているようなスタンスでいるよな。
ちゃんと教えられる側という自覚はあるのか？
うっさい、ボケただけじゃん。ブーブーうっさい。
Yosuke was relentlessly repeating the NG tone without saying a word.He was pressing one button so he was still full of energy, unlike Rin, who was reacting to the sound every time and exhausting herself. She pointed at the wall clock with a pained look.
Dare ga 3分で終了なんて言った？できるまでやるんだ。
鬼だ。みんなが鬼とかした。
やらせようとしていることは小学生でもできることなんだがな。
ならお前できるのか？
話をそらすな。
今からやる。リキ、もう一回やってくれ。
No way. From Class 2E, pleased to meet you. Resisting the high-pitched buzzing, I repeated one more time.
今こいつどもったぞ。なんで私に鳴らすんだ。
It means get to it already.
私に恨みでもあるのか。くそ、このバカ兄貴め。
Actually, I don't really understand Ren's mental condition, seeing how she's been desperately avoiding doing things so trivial all this time. She seemed even further worn down. Oh my god. Don't ask the impossible, Ren's plenty exhausted by now. Right after the bell rang. She like fought on the desk and appealed in a broken voice. The future was looking grim.
さて、ここからはシミュレーションだ。ケンゴとマサトをお偉いさんに見立てて、学校を案内してみせるんだ。
いいだろう。任せておけ。心得た。わかりました。
Her success rate was beyond low.
Kengo, 理事長役頼むぞ。
うん。俺は？
お前は議員役だ。偉そうに、その後しっぽりムフフと行きたいものですな。とか言ってればいい。
オーケ
ー。Jesus。
ではまず校長に挨拶をしたい。 校長室まで案内してもらおうか。
その後しっぽりムフフと行きたいものですな。
お前校長としっぽりムフフと行くのか。
Ren, Masato hurt himself what hasn't realized this, but it's actually Kyosuke's trap to provoke you. You shouldn't fall for it.
なるほど。
Please follow us this way. I took the lead. Ren didn't budge, so I pulled her along by the sleeve. We started walking side by side. Ren, you're gonna actually have to come with us? Four people can't walk together in the corridor, so I was out of the group, with Kengo and Masato coming along after me, and finally Ren trailing behind us. The NG tone rang from behind me. Something wrong.
惜しいな。見ろ。向かいから二人組の生徒が来る。マサトが廊下の中央を歩きすぎていたんだ。このままだとぶつかると思ったリンは、その袖を引っ張って右側に引き寄せたんだ。
いけないことだったのか？
No, it's the way you did it that's wrong. I took care of the explanation. In times like these, you have to warn the person not pull on their sleeve yourself.You should tell them that it's dangerous that they should walk a little to the right or so.
なるほどな。
But she had noticed that even before me, who was walking ahead of everyone. She must have been really careful, watchful. Ren's trying her best. I'm sure that if she keeps at it for the rest of the day, she'll be okay tomorrow. She won't be. It's the principal's office. I stepped before the office and pointed to the door.
では、二人はここで入っていって校長と話をして。また出てきたとしよう。はい、スタート。
ん？待っていてくれたのか？悪いな。
偶然です。当然です。どっちもあかんのだったらどうしろっちゅうんじゃボケ。
Saying of course is too serious for a student, and saying it's a coincidence just plain strange. A simple it's okay and not at all compare coupled with a smile would be much better.
なんか腑に落ちないな。
That's how any student would normally react. Just keep it up. She nodded reluctantly.
Hmm? 待っていてくれたのか。悪い。
はい。
Where should we take you next?
君たちの授業を見学させてもらうことになっているから、君たちの教室まで頼む。
Understood.
その後はしっぽりムフフと行きたいものですね。
犯罪だな。
I told you not to fall for that. I took a position at the head of the group once again. This time even I noticed when a group of girls came striding toward us. The leader was... Sasami Sasasegawa. Yes!
Sasami-da!
No! Rin sprang out up in front of... upon noticing her.
Arega Sasami-ni gozaimasu!
Sasami-senpai!
Jesus.
Warera ga shikuteki.
One of her groupies noticed us.
また現れましたの？
ササミ、邪魔だ、どけ！
Ren.
どけですって？そちらこそ目障りでございましてよ。
障りだと？
やる気ですの？
であれば望むところだが、今日のところは見逃しておいてやる。
Jesus.
なぜならば、ブーブーうっさいじゃボケ。
Even if she gives it her all, I might not see this working out by tomorrow.
その音、一体何の余興ですの？
あら、宮沢さんもご一緒していらしたの？
お前たち、道を開けて差し上げなさい。邪魔ですことよ。
They were commanded to step aside, and the crowd split into two to open up a path.
すげえな、おい。
We freely passed through the middle. I felt like walking on a red carpet.
宮沢さん、今度、お茶でもご一緒にいかがでございますか？
Sasasegawa asked Kengo as we passed by.
暇ができたらな。
その後、しっぽりムフフと行きたいものですね。
Oh my god.
Sasami-senpai!
As soon as we walked past her, Sasasegawa fainted. Oh man. When Masato said was too much for her to handle, she's quite an innocent one herself.
授業が始まります。急ぎましょう。
This is our classroom. The bell rang as we entered the classroom.
よし、今回はここまでだ。次は昼休みか。食堂で食事マナーの勉強だな。
Her spirit plummeted once again. We grabbed the usual trays and took our usual seats. I don't like this noise. Ren and I had our meals picked for us today.
では始めるとするか。
This is the Komori stuff. Thanks for the food.
いただきます。
Following my lead, Ren put her hands together. Then we simultaneously picked up the chopsticks and started eating. Kyosuke's cell phone was pointed at Ren's chest. I wasn't sure what was going on.
箸の持ち方だ。
Kinga pointed out. I took a closer look to realize that she was holding the chopsticks in an extremely strange way.
どうして人差し指と中指がクロスしているんだ?
This is where I just check out and be like, okay.
個性だ。個性です。ゆとり教育です。すみません、直します。
箸は上側の箸だけを動かして使うものだ。まず下側の箸は親指の付け根で挟み、しっかりと固定し、薬指の先を添えるようにして持つ。上側の箸は根元が 1-2 センチ出るくらいの部分を持ち、人差し指と中指の先で軽く挟んで親指を添えろ。
What?
お前そんな格好でよく真面目に説明できるな。
That makes no sense to me.I'll just take a fucking fork. We were being taught the table manners, starting with the proper way to hold chopsticks.
箸の使い方でやってはいけないことがいくつかある。リキ、思いつくものをあげてみろ。
Waving your chopsticks above the dish or using them to draw the dish closer.
そうだな。
People do that.
リン、他には。
相手に突き刺す。
I mean, you shouldn't do that.
何?相手を箸で突き刺してもいいのか?
問題外という意味だ。
アホだな。
何？お前に言われたくないわ、ボケ！お前に言われたくありません、ボケ！大変ボケていらっしゃるようだ。大層頭がおボケとお見受け。
Knock it off, friend. There's no correct way to say it.
他には、差し箸なんかが代表だろうな。子供のように、箸先で刺すことだ。
What?
相手じゃないぞ。おかずをだぞ。リキのあげたのは迷い箸、寄せ箸だな。他にも渡し箸、ねぶり箸、もぎ箸などもある。
Stop! 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 His lecture went on. How to eat, how to use utensils, and even the correct posture. A fork and knife is just so much easier. Thanks for the food.
ごちそうさまでした。
I clasped my hands together after I finished dinner.We were silently waiting for Kyosuke's next words.
Yes, 今回はここまで。
At the same moment, Rin collapsed face on flat on the table. She was completely exhausted. Poor Rin. She vanished somewhere after school, and I was looking for her. She'd looked depressed, so I was worried about her.I passed through the courtyard into the passageway where she'd normally be playing with her cats. As I was walking around the tree, I finally spotted her figure in the shade behind it. I was about to call out to her, but stopped myself. She was sitting with her arms wrapped around her legs, her head hanging. Meow. The cats around her felt that she was different from your usual self and were puzzled. She was so tired that she even didn't care about the two cats playing behind King of the Hill on her head. Meow meow. Lennon, who had been lying on the lawn staring at Rin, pawed up at her and tugged at the edge of her skirt with his paw.
How did you do it? I'm fighting with Boo Boo On now. I'm exhausted. Let me go. Boo Boo On is dead.
She spoke in a sulky voice.Well, it was a battle so tough that I really could almost imagine her dropping dead. Meow meow. But Lennon didn't give up and stopped moving his paw. She slowly lifted her head up and extended her left arm. Then she patted Lennon on the forehead. She bent her index finger and rubbed his forehead in a swirling motion. Meow.
私に逆らう気か。10年早いわ。うりうり。
ミャオ。
必殺、猫の額は意外とでっかいぞ攻撃。
She used her hand to rub his entire head. Meow.
情けない声出さないの。男の子でしょ。
Meow. He started licking her fingers.
こら、くすぐったい。もうしょうがないな、レナ。
She fell on her knees, giggling.
おいで、レナ。
Meow. All the other cats took this opportunity to surround her. She was buried under her cats in a matter of seconds. I didn't get a chance to intervene. The cats already made her recover her spirits. It was a refreshing morning. The weather was flawless.I shot a glance at the clock, and it was still only 8 a.m. I'd usually be getting myself ready at this time, at around this time. Rin was sleepy to the point where she was struggling to keep her eyes open. I wasn't surprised seeing how she had had a rough time yesterday.Are you okay?
大丈夫。任せろ。
Her voice was drowsy. She didn't appear all right to me. A black luxury car halted in the front of the gate. An old man, whom I had seen somewhere before, and a fit-looking man got out of it. That old man must be the superintendent.He did bear an uncanny resemblance to the statue. So that the other man must be the representative of the prefectural assembly. Alright, mission start. We proceed to the great visitor, greet the visitors together with our homeroom teacher.
本日はご足労ありがとうございます。学内の案内ですが、2年 E 組の直江と夏目がご案内いたします。
We took a step forward after being introduced.Hello, I'm Naoi from Class 2E. Please take your time with the inspection. He seemed the type to always have a smile on his face. I felt relieved, seeing that he looked like a kind person. I shook his hand and took a step back. It was Rin's turn. She didn't turn to the assembly member, but to me.She spelled out the words as if trying to point out that it already hadn't gone according to the plan. She was right. He made such a good impression on me that I got carried away and changed the words a bit. Just follow the plan, Ren, I whispered to her. He asked our homeroom teacher while looking at Ren, but before he had time to answer, she took a step forward. She mixed up the greetings.
よろしく。
He took his time to meet her. He chuckled heartily after that.
面白い子だね。
Well, he didn't seem to have gotten that bad of an impression of her, so it's all good.
おはようございます。おはようっす。
The students passing through the school gates were greeting each other. It was the usual scene we saw every morning. The superintendent was whispering something to the assembly member every now and then. Rin and I simply stood to the side.
君たちは寮住まいですか?
はい。リキと一緒に暮らしてます。
We're living together now.
間違った。リキは男子寮で、私は女子寮に住んでます。
Ren, it's not like they know my name, my first name. I'm wondering the fur in a small voice. Naoe. Stop talking to me and get on with the explanation already. Am I a pervert? Our homeroom teacher was turning pale in the face. How should I remedy this situation? Both Natsumi and I live in the dorms over there. I pointed in the direction of the dormitories. It can be pretty tough sometimes, but it's a lot of fun. Not only roommates, but all the students living in the dormitory help each other. It's a wonderful coexistence thanks to everyone's hard work.
そうですか? Natsume-san も楽しいですか?
はい、それは大層楽しいです。
それは良かったですね。
She didn't stop using strange words, but thanks to the assembly member being a nice person, didn't cause much problems. Those two visitors sitting behind us and observing. The superintendent and the assembly member. He guided the chalk rapidly across the board, tapping it loudly on the blackboard in the end and turning to us. He asked us. A sea of hands flew up, and one holding his hand together higher than anyone else was none other than Masato. No! Actually, he was already on his feet.
Oh, no.
He gave a clear answer and walked toward the blackboard. He was standing there in a beautiful posture, holding his chin up and his back straight. He picked up a piece of chalk, then with incredible speed, put the answer on the blackboard. He set down the chalk, brushed his hands off, and turned toward the teacher. Why French? It sparked a burst of applause in the classroom. The truth is that Masato spent the whole night preparing for this lesson. His posture was that of a valiant knight, his eyes were red. He cut his training hours by half and studied instead to have a dramatic effect on his test results. Masato returned to his seat and a look of accomplishment on his face, high-fiving everyone on his way back. At the end, he high-fived me too. You did well, Masato. Leave the rest to us. Don't sleep in class. He sat down and took out a 12-inch long ruler. He rested his chin on it and closed his eyes. How can he ever sleep like that? I slept in some weird ass positions. The assembly member praised us after the class was over. Neither of them joined us in our classroom after the lunch break. We'll stop to escort them back after school, so they're probably having a talk somewhere. All the students were completely tired out by the stress.
Inohara, shizuka ni nero.
Fucking Inohara. Once the classes were over, I loosened up my posture and sighed it with relief. Yosuke was sitting on the windowsill. Yeah, I know that. I hope that's all. That was tiring as well, but compared to having to keep the VIP's company, it was still better. I heard the chime of the PA system calling out attention to a broadcast. Here goes. Rin sprung up to her feet and looked at me. Well, we have to go.
Huh?
We can't fuck it up now. If my fears were confirmed, we weren't asked to only escort them back. Huh? Asked one more time. Oh no. Oh no. Oh god, no. Please no. This envoy member stated that that way they were interested in the sport, that they were interested in the sports club. The reason being, it was a perfectly valid reason. I see. Of course, there was no way to refuse. Let's start with the sports ground then. Oh, God. Oh, God. Sorry? Well, Kengo is, but... Yeah, I do. That's fine. I awakened to my mistake after he said this. If you wanted to see how the sports grounds were being utilized, Kengo, who's training in the dojo, would be of no help to him at all. What should I do now? I shot a glance at my left. To my left, Rin couldn't possibly have a friend like that. No, I was just thinking you don't have a friend in any of the sports clubs, do you? Ah! Asked her quietly. Sasimi Sasasegawa! Yes! Where? Even though I asked her, only one person came to mind. Sasami Sasasegawa! She smacked Rin on the head. She grumbled but didn't fight back. She was holding back so that it wouldn't develop into a fight like usual. I got a bad feeling from her words. With Rin having to act docile, Sasasegawa could be planning to use this opportunity to get back at her.
ソフトボール部の佐々瀬川佐々美と申します。2年で4番とピッチャーを任されております。おお、それはすごいですな。大したことありませんわ。妥当なポジションでしょ。その私にどのようなご用件でしょうか。夏目さんのご友人に運動部がグラウンドの使用で困っている話を伺いに来たのですよ。なるほど。
The superintendent was standing next to the assembly member. There was a perfect chance for her to get rid of the Sandlot team that wasn't even registered as a club. She only had to inform him of us. We would likely be criticized by the superintendent, and we would never step on the sports grounds again. If they judged that there was hence no need to expand the grounds, we'd failed the mission as well. It was a perfect setup for revenge. Rin hadn't thought things through that well. She'd mentioned her name only because no one else came to mind. I should have noticed this earlier and prevented it. In one flowing speech, Sasasegawa perfectly and coherently articulated the state of affairs in the sports clubs. Completely unlike her usual exaggerated, haughty tone, she was explaining in a wondrously straightforward manner. I was just looking at her in blank amazement. What's more, she didn't mention our Sandlot team even once. Thank you, Sasami Sasasegawa.
Thank you.
I'll have to repay you later.